All right. Hey, everyone. Welcome to the second episode of our Togal interview series. We're joined today by Brad Brady, president of Total Flooring. Thanks for being here today, Brad.
Hey, thank you for having me.
No problem. So I figured we'd just kick it off and have you tell us a little bit more about your role with Total Flooring and your journey over the last several years.
Yeah, of course. You know, I'm the active president of Total Flooring for the last basically 4 years. I have a history of being a general contractor doing large projects and made the switch over into the sub side. And man, what a roller coaster it's been just trying to learn the industry, learn the ins and outs. But it's been a great ride. Great ride.
Awesome. So you say you originally got in on the general contracting side. How long were you doing that before jumping here, and what made you want to switch into the flooring industry?
Yeah, so I've been in the construction industry for about 15 years. Went to school for construction management, started as an intern, bottom floor, and just kind of worked my way up. And I've been traveling across the country doing sizable projects. Did a large renovation of a mall in Long Island. And then right before I made the switch, I just finished a ground up, probably one of the last malls new in the country in Connecticut. And this was a subcontractor working on the job with me, and over mutual basically dinner, found out they had a need. I was wanting not to keep traveling with my family across country, and came to an agreement where they were going to teach me the industry and I was going to help them understand construction from a different point of view. So it was a perfect marriage. It's been a crazy ride, because that all started right when COVID hit. So I came to a new company and started the lead into different markets when there was no really work going on. Anything that anyone had stopped. But big picture wise, it was a blessing in disguise. And we took a company that's been doing this for 34 years and was able to remarket it and get into other sectors, mainly in the Florida area. But we work nationwide. So we've done a mall in California, successfully, but we've also now grown into multifamily in the South Florida market, which is a hard market to get into. So.
Awesome. That's exciting. Seems like there's probably just over the last 3 years, three and a half, 4 years, because of COVID, there's probably been more changes just in the construction industry in general than there was the 5 or 10 years before then. But how has it been just in the last 4 years, or however long it's been since you joined Total Flooring? Like, how have you seen the industry as a whole change? I mean, whether it be with software in general, just how projects are ran, timelines, processes, like, what are some things that have stood out to you there?
Yeah. I mean, the first thing that comes to mind is, people. Nothing that we do is going to happen without the people, and people's priorities and needs definitely change. So we have seen on job sites, different ways that they manage it, the people's safety. The fact is that you need to be more flexible with them. Everyone's having to navigate those waters and be able to meet in different formats. For instance, just like this, using an online video call software. In my history, I never did any sort of interview or anything like this that wasn't in person. Since COVID, I've seen a lot of that going on. Any way that we can discuss or go over things with a little distance. And then there's always now that were past COVID to a degree, the final let's go meet, let's have that in-person meeting, because there's certain things that this doesn't do. But yeah, having to work in different environments, that's definitely, we've seen that. I mean, I can talk about, you know, how products are, you know, more scarce and harder to get and all that, but having to use technologies, having to use things to fight and problem solve everything, it's been a journey for sure, and we've had to adapt and use different things to make our projects a success. So
nice. Yeah, I imagine for the construction industry, it's probably couldn't have been more difficult for, you know, any industry out there to adapt to what COVID brought to us, because you're not used to doing things over Zoom meetings, and, you know, you're used to being in person and everything like that. You got to be in the field, you got to be at the office. And I'd imagine that the biggest softwares that were probably adopted by construction companies were Microsoft Teams and Skype, or, you know, Zoom, whatever it may be. But it sounds like you guys have responded to some of these changes very well over the last few years. I guess in terms of software, I mean, Togal is obviously one of them. Is there anything else that you guys have adopted or changed, either with software or just with roles and expanding responsibilities that have helped you guys get
there? Yeah. So what we do to manage our current projects is we use like Slack. So we made a channel per project. So anything that is a project specific conversation happens on that channel. And, you know, we're a large enough, but yet small enough company that, you know, me being the president or my VP of operations or the project manager or the superintendent or whoever is involved, we can keep a pulse on that job and step in when we need to step in or understand where we're at on a certain project. So it's communication, man. I mean, it's like anything, the better you can communicate, the better data you have, the better, you know, takeoff you have, all those things helps making projects a success, and seeing issues come up before they're completely stopping a job, you know, we're short on this or whatever, being able to see that and communicate it has been key. We've definitely had to be flexible, you know, with where we are. So me, I'm always on a plane or in a hotel or whatever. So being able to do all that stuff from anywhere has been a huge success. But one thing is communicating. The other thing is understanding the project. So, I mean, we're here to talk about Togal. So being able to jump in internet-based and look at any project and see what we do or what we don't have, you know, just from the sheer takeoff standpoint has been a huge success for me. Because, you know, I don't have to go into our cloud-based system and open a file and do this and do that. I can literally just log on and go to the project in a quick, you know, search and then navigate the plans knowing what I'm looking for. But I'm, you know, a president. If I'm looking into those things, it's more for kind of a right then and there kind of conversation. My project managers live in it every day, you know, that kind of thing.
No, it's a great point. I mean, And you think about that feature too, just online web-based collaboration. That's not even artificial intelligence or AI, right? It's just basic framework of having your information in one centralized location. And, you know, we feel like that's one of the things that takeoff and estimating programs have been a little bit limited to over the years, just because they're more on-prem solutions and not necessarily on the web, like a lot of the operations softwares are, communication softwares like Slack. Just great software, great product. We use that all the time as well. But yeah, let's definitely talk about some Togal. How'd you find out originally about Togal?
Well, someone here called me. It was a great story. So we were out at a clay shoot with CASF, and we were currently, you know, sitting there next to Moss Construction, shooting clays, having a good time, building relationships, right? And you called me and I stepped away and I said, you know, hey, listen, I hear the pitch. And I said, I'm going to give you 30 seconds, right? Give me your pitch in 30 seconds. That's what I can give you, because I was right in the middle of it with clients. And you pitched me on it to the point that I said, all right, let's set up the trial period. Let's set up a little further conversation, because we had recently, the timing was perfect, because we had recently gone through a number of changes under my, you know, time in the seat of how we were doing our estimating. So to give you a quick back history here. So we had three full-time estimators, old school estimators. And, you know, when I got started, the name of the game was bid work, land work, find work, because no one had it. Everything was stopped. Anything you could get, you had to be aggressive on, and you had to do it. And through that process, we had a roles and responsibilities that they would just do the takeoff. And then it got handed off to someone else that did the material pricing. And then it went to kind of a project management role to put the fine tune on it and get out the door and follow up with the client. Well, anytime there was a question, I mean, there's three people involved with answering that question, and a lot of time and inefficiencies that were happening. So we started trying to slim that down, making the roles and responsibilities more to an individual person. And we had a project manager slash estimator kind of role born. So from that standpoint, that person was doing the takeoff, doing the material request. And when we would go meet with the client, they knew the job better than anybody. Any estimator normally would know the job better than anybody. But now they're at the table when we're talking about negotiations or answering questions in an interview, and they know it better than anybody. They know, you know, what they're 100% on, or what they're 80% still have questions on, so they can ask those questions. And that was a great formula. But what happened was, when you started bidding work and then you start landing it, you have to manage that work. So the work management to bidding ratio kept pivoting. So if you had work, you were doing less bidding. And then when you didn't have work, you were bidding, but you didn't have work. You know what I mean? So we had great success with that position, but then we had problems keeping the pipeline filled with that. With that being said, you know, we had tried some outsourcing of some takeoff, did not have success there, and we were looking for solutions. So long story short, when you called, you basically were promising us something that was going to speed our process up, and we were very interested in it, and grateful that you called. Yes.
Yeah, it was perfect timing. You made it pretty easy on me to at least let you guys check it out and explore it. So definitely appreciate that. And gosh, it's been almost 2 years now. So beginning of 22. So you guys were not just, you know, customers of Togal, you were very early adopters. I think we had released the product like 3 or 4 months prior to that. So a lot of the features and stuff we won't really get into today, it didn't even exist at the time. I think it was basically just, it was web-based takeoff software. It allowed you to do all the normal manual measurements and everything in there. And then we had the AI tool that could do a lot of the measuring and everything for you, but it wasn't even as fine tuned and great as it is now, just in terms of accuracy and everything. So we greatly appreciate you sticking with us from the beginning and giving it a shot. And speaking of that, I mean, you know, I gave you a call. I think we tested it for a couple of weeks, or gave you guys some trial licenses for it. And then you guys purchased a pilot with us for some number of months. And then from there, it turned into just a, you know, standard customer. But what was that like for you bringing it to the team? You know, you it seemed like you were either sold on it or sold on the idea of exploring it right away, but there's always the thought of how do I get the estimating team and the project managers to learn a new software or to even want to learn a new software? And what was that, you know, implementation or transition period like for you?
Yeah, I mean, I'll be completely transparent. So, you know, as a leader, you know, I'm not shoving anything down anyone's throat. So we had a group discussion. They were in all of those trials. At the end of the day, it was really their decision. And I have a younger estimating project management team. And at the end of the day, what I discovered was you have to listen to your people. You have to trust what they're telling you, because I personally, you know, struggled with it a little bit versus how they did things. And that was because of my older school method of how my brain works. You know, I personally, I'm so used to having a paper copy right here, having my computer here, having another, you know, screen over here. And when I'm going through doing my takeoff, my brain is asking me all these questions. I'm answering them right then and there. I'm doing a lot of research in the moment when I'm trying to decide if the tile turns that corner of that wall. You know, that's how my brain works. Their brain was able to say, okay, let's use this AI software, save tons of time, and let us get the 70, 80% of the takeoff done like that, right? And then let us be disciplined enough that we back up and we start from the beginning and we answer those questions, but we already know the generic square footage of something. Right. We already know how big of a project this is that we're talking about, because we need that information to go get pricing of the materials to know if we're talking about 10,000 square feet or 200,000 square foot of a certain material. There's different price points. Right. So they were the decision makers. They saw the value in being able to get the pricing request started and not wait until the very end of all the takeoff being perfect. And they love the way that it does things, and then they can come back and manipulate it, because it says, oh, this is a bedroom, or this is a living room, or this is a bathroom. You know, the reality is we bid and do pre-construction on various percentiles of complete documents. So if you're doing the 100%, man, it's there. You can see it. If you're doing the 60%, they might not know if what they're doing in the bedroom, but being able to say it's X amount of square foot of bedroom and tell them this is your carpet price versus if you change it to LVT versus tile, like that's what Togal does really well, is being able to get us to a certain point very quickly to be able to do certain things in budgets or in our pricing that normally we would be waiting another week to get to that point, to be able to start that. So,
right. Yeah. That's really interesting stuff. And I'm sure everybody watching right now, I mean, whether you're a GC, a flooring company, a drywaller, or really any kind of trade, I mean, they're probably all wondering, like, what exactly is the AI? What does it do? What are its capabilities, or maybe what are its limitations, or, you know, non-possibilities of doing something? And, you know, for you guys, obviously for the flooring side of things, I can see it on our website and see some of the videos on YouTube, how it goes in there and, like, you know, it draws all the areas right away. And that's giving you guys more time to spend inside of the, you know, specifications or the flooring notes or other pages with all the actual details on those projects. Where does the estimating tie in? Because I think that would be like the one question every flooring company watching this would think, and we could spend 30 minutes on this, obviously, at the end of the day, but what they'll come to find is Togal's just a takeoff tool. We don't have the estimating and the pricing built in. And a lot of flooring companies have the question of waste and, you know, all the extra material that has to get calculated from there. So you're saying that doing the takeoff a lot faster has helped you guys maybe put more time into the estimating side of things, either, you know, in spreadsheets or wherever that information lives. Is that?
Yeah. I mean, I'll tell you this. So, you know, I can only speak to the programs that we've used in the past. And at the end of the day, when we've always wanted to see if there's better software or better system out there, what we've discovered is it's really hard to find a software that fits all of our needs, right? So we're sacrificing something. And what 99% of the time we found is that flexibility wasn't there. So if it's a client that wants to see things broken out by building or, you know, by material type, or everyone has their own individual way of looking at it, how they want the numbers, because their owners have different buckets of money that they need to put their decision-making into. So from that standpoint, yes, we use basically Excel bid master that we have a tab for carpet or for wood or for tile, whatever it might be. And we've built in the, you know, must haves with the setting materials and this and that. The deal is for us, Togal allows us to get the takeoffs done faster. And like you said, more time to deal with the details, you know, more time to come up with the questions that the drawings don't show. And they allow us to let the estimators do what estimators do. And they're not robots. They're intelligent, looking at these problems, so we can educate our clients and they can educate their clients, right? As far as, does it do pricing for you? No, but at the end of the day, I'm not aware of, in the flooring industry, of a software that has a contact with the hundreds of different brokers that we have to deal with on their custom tiles and their pricing. I mean, I don't know if you know this, but you can't pick up the phone and call and say, hey, what's the price of this tile, without answering 20 questions, right? They want to know what project it's for, who was the architect, when's it going to happen, what's the square footage, you know, what's your delivery methods, all these things. They won't even respond to you most of the time without having all of that answered. So there's not a system out there that has the relationship with all these people that's going to give you these quotes, right? The reality is, you know, they say the same tile for different prices to different people. It depends on who made the deal in their side of their company. And, you know, you have to have a relationship with them. So software is not going to solve that, right? You got to have that relationship and be able to answer all those questions to be able to get there. You know, the other thing that I'll say about Togal is that we've been able to adapt its simplicity, right, and grow our team. And what I mean by that is, being a project manager / estimator, you're a busy person, right? So what we've been able to do is we brought in some part-time help. And they understand now, they did not start in the industry at all, but we've been able to teach them that, hey, this is how you upload a set of plans. This is how you set the scale. This is how you double check the scale. This is how you hit go and you get that Togal AI software to give you the first pass on the whole job, and then bundle it up and hand it to an estimator and say, all right, this project is 70%. Because I did the first pass of Togal and I've done the material request and here's the pricing, right? You take it from here. That's all we really envisioned was going to happen. And reality is, you know, these individuals have grown so rapidly in the past year that they're now getting bids to I'm going to say 90 percentile readiness. And my estimators are spending the time double checking and asking the questions and saying, have you looked at this detail? Do you know if, does the flooring go underneath the millwork or does it stop, right? Does it go up the wall and what's the waterproofing and all these questions? I mean, the more they're asked, the more they're engaged, the more they learn, and they're getting things better and better and faster and faster. and it's in-house. That's the main thing for me is if I have a question about a job, I want to be able to pick up the phone or get on a call and, you know, talk to the person that was in it. And I'm just blown away how using this software, using part-time people and partnering with my seasoned estimators, how much faster we're getting more work out. Like, it's insane the amount of work that we are bidding and getting out the door with the limited staff that we have on it. It's really amazing.
That's awesome. Yeah, I think that's a great way to wrap things up, because there's so many misconceptions with AI and artificial intelligence. You know, even in my role, like, we look at software and our first thought is like, well, is the AI going to be able to do this like our other software does? And then can it do the next step and then the next step and then the next step? And in all reality, you know, you keep going down that line. At the end of the day, what you're talking about is like replacing the person that's actually using the existing software that you have, which just really isn't, you know, realistic. But if we can take you from, you know, a blank drawing and get you whatever that takeoff is, that first pass, maybe it's 20% for somebody, or maybe it's 50%, or for you guys, 90% of the way, starting at 90% or starting at 50% is way better than starting at ground zero and having to do all the tedious work when you would rather be sitting there calling vendors for pricing or your clients or.
Yeah. I mean, at the end of the day, and I would tell this to anyone, you know, it's a tool, and you have to put the right tools in your people's hands to be able to support them and do things that, you know, you're wanting to do as far as growth or speed or whatever. You know, is it going to do your job for you? No. Right? Has it greatly increased the way that we look and bid and timeframes? I mean, I'll take an example right now. We were given 48 hours from the time that we got a call to the time that we were sitting down and reviewing a number. We were given 48 hours to take off a 30-story high-rise in South Florida, right? And normally you're talking 2 weeks of going through there and clicking the corners on every floor of the unit, the corridors, and doing all that mind-numbing work to just get into the details and get everything put together. I mean, trust me, we kill ourselves. We stay there late. But using a software like this, like, it sped that process up so fast that we were able to really fine-tune the details. And when we sit down in the meeting, and in my opinion, you know, the number's one thing, right? The cost of the work, the proposal is one thing. The confidence that you have it right, the knowing that your subcontractor knows what they're talking about, has brought three things to your attention that we need to discuss, and not just said, we'll figure it out later. Because being in my GC shoes, that's not what you want to do. You want to cap your risk. You want to make sure you're knowing what is in and not in that number, and you're on the same page when you sign that contract, right? So you got to have confidence in your subcontractor and your people. And that's what this software has done, is taken something that would take us 2 weeks to really feel comfortable and get through all those things, to being able to run it through the system, go back and spend all the time in the details and how this condition is going to be taken care of, and how we're going to discuss logistics and how we're going to get the pricing and all that thing. I mean, I'm not lying. It was literally 48 hours. That's for something that we were going to take 2 weeks normally to do and get out the door. And we landed that job, and we're over 60%. Yeah. We're over 60% complete with that job right now. And it's a huge success. And now we're in conversations about a second building. And, you know, at the end of the day, it goes back to, you know, having the data right, having the price right, having the quality to back it up, having the right personnel. And this, in my opinion, Togal is a piece of that success to get us to the table to be the right fit for our client.
That's awesome. Awesome. Well, I guess that'll do it for the second series of the interview. process here. So appreciate your time, Brad. You and the entire team as well. I know Veronica and Steven and everyone that we work with there is, I'm probably forgetting some names here, but appreciate them as well. It's been awesome working with them and hoping that all of our new features and things that we've been releasing since you guys signed up have been helpful as well. And there's always more to come. We're always innovating and looking for new things to add into the product. And for anybody watching, if you haven't figured it out already, you can go right to our website, it's Togal.AI, and you can request a demo. We've got a contact form. You can send us a message, and a member of our team will be in touch with you as soon as possible. So
there you do it. I'll tell you this. You guys listen to when we say, hey, we wish it would do this a little differently. You guys actually back it up, and it's not going to happen overnight, but there's been some things that we've talked about that we've seen changes in about 2 months' time that is makes all the difference to us. And thank you for working with us and understanding our needs, you know, because you're trying to meet the needs of a lot of different platforms. So I really appreciate it, Nick and Togal team. Thank you very much.
Yes, definitely a big shout out to our development team. I just relay the message and they make the magic work and get it done. So, but awesome. Well, thanks again, Brad. It was great catching up and look forward to talking with you again soon.
Take care.
Thanks. See you.